young carriers. How much kids spread COVID-19? COVID-19 cases in the U.S. surged again. While local officials are wrestling with the pandemic, one study found something crucial. The Icelandic study observed definitive evidence on children's ability to spread COVID-19. Scientists at the Directorate of Health and Decode Genetics joined forces to monitor each adult and child in Iceland. These individuals were quarantined after being likely exposed this spring. According to National Geographic, the study had 40,000 participants, including children under 15 years. Evidence suggested that children could get COVID-19 around half as likely as adults. Simultaneously, children with COVID-19 could transmit the coronavirus to others half as likely as adults. When viewed in real-world conditions, children could spread the disease to adults. And to make it worse, children are more likely asymptomatic or have milder symptoms. If their symptom is just a cold, many people may not consider COVID-19. Carrie Stephenson, chief executive of Decode, said, "They can and do get infected and transmit to others, but they do both less frequently than adults." But if children do not get infected or transmit COVID-19 frequently, why are some outbreaks associated with schools? The answer lies within households with school-aged children. Although experts cannot fully explain it, children are less likely to experience severe COVID-19 than adults. When a school-aged child with COVID-19 is detected, they are sealed off from the community. So, they stay indoors at home with their families. Obviously, adults will provide care for their children. This increases the risk of catching the coronavirus. If the child is a silent carrier, their physical contact with family members will balloon that risk. And since adults are more vulnerable to severe COVID-19, it will put older adults in danger, especially grandparents. The next crucial factor is behavior. It contradicts the assumption that biology dictates transmission. A person who is living inside a bubble is unlikely to get exposed to pathogens or chemicals. But a person who makes direct contact with lots of things may get sick or share harmful elements with others. Kids younger than 14 years could enhance transmission risk based on an Indian study. This is because preteens and teens tend to have more physical contact with others. It is just a part of their socialization. The takeaway is children aged between 10 and 12 are more likely to get and transmit the coronavirus. The COVID monitor revealed that high school case rates in the U.S. were almost three times than in elementary schools.